argument does not do that, or at least should not do that, if it wants to avoid the kind of main thrust of the academy.
Thank you, that's helpful, Katie. Let me ask one question. Last weekend at Lexington, one of our team, well, the team we have there in the doubles debated an argument which literally said, and there was a piece of evidence, and I won't say it exactly the way the evidence was phrased or something, but argued that because our 1HC is a white guy, that whites screw everything up, and therefore you ought to lose. Now, I wasn't there, I was at the JV State tournament here, but I don't know if that description of the argument by our students is accurate, but if so, have you heard about it, and what might be a viable way to answer that?
Yeah, that is a, that argument is not unfounded in the scholarship on the more kind of extreme spectrum of anti-blackness. The exclusion of, it's the all black everything kind of concept, that the inclusion of non-black folks into the struggle against anti-blackness does more harm than good. It's more potentially dangerous than positive. So we should exclude white folks, particularly, from kind of engaging with our struggles. So that argument is well founded. There are people that respond to that. Tim Wise is one, who is a white guy and is pretty anti-racist, or, writes about being anti-racist at the very least. He writes a lot of responses to that. But it's also just you have to defend the ability of non-black folks to engage in Afro-pessimistic struggles to be against civil society. And, I'm sure debate gets explained as reductionistly as possible. It's just like, you're white and you lose. But there is a finding in the scholarship, or a basis in the scholarship, rather, for a question of how productive it is to include coalitions in Afro-pessimist struggles with non-black folks. So I think just really defending the concept of coalitions would help in that instance, as well as kind of framing the debate in a way that makes the student who is white, they understand their positionality within the debate. But that would be my suggestion for that argument. And that argument is, like I said, there's lots of the Afro-pessimist literature which would support the argument.
Could you include the citation to the Weiss evidence in what you sent to Kelly tomorrow as well?
Yep, I've added that to the template.
Do we have any more questions or comments from our audience? Okay, well, let me thank Gabe for taking 2 hours out of his busy coaching schedule, to talk to us. And we hope that the evidence and some of the arguments will also be given a wider scope of reference once you send that material to Kelly. But I will say that the folks who chose not to be here, especially those that are fairly close to the Wayne State campus, missed, I think, an excellent talk, some excellent explanations and strategies, and we wish you well at your next series of tournaments, which may be like Kansas State or a few others like that, or.
Yeah, we'll leave on Friday for Wichita.
Good luck. Thank you. Good seeing you again, Gabe. And thank
good to see you. I didn't see anybody good to hear everybody. Thank you very much for listening. I'll be in contact with Kelly for evidence and hopefully setting up some future things to talk to y'all again. So thank you very much.
Thank you. Okay. And thank you for coming on this somewhat snowy day.
Yes.
Okay. I hope that you took away some good ideas, strategies, arguments, and you will get more in the near future, or hopefully by this weekend or next week. Okay?
Thank you so much. Yeah.
All right. Thank you. I think there's probably still a few slices back there if you want to take some on the way out. Grab a water if you're still thirsty. Okay. Thank you very much. And Craig, thank you. And Kelly, obviously, for sticking around to run the technical side.
Yeah, you can go to my office because that's where all this is going. Yeah.